Welcome back to our five-part video series on pump sleeves and the inflatable drum sander. So far, we have examined the differences between the pump sleeve and the product that is often confused with the pump sleeve, the spiral band, also known as the no-lap band, or the sanding sleeve. We have talked about the proper measuring techniques used to obtain a properly fitting pump sleeve. Finally, we've covered some maintenance checks and services, and even examined the repair kit that we have available should the need arise to replace some components. In this video, we will disassemble an inflatable drum, examine it for maintenance issues, and reassemble it. As we disassemble this particular inflatable drum, keep in mind that although most drums have the same basic structure, there are still some slight differences. For instance, the number of screws that hold the end cap on the end of the body, or how the bladder is sealed to the drum caps to keep the air from escaping. We begin by removing the four screws that hold the end cap on the drum. Next, we'll flip the drum end for end and repeat the procedure. Remove the end cap by applying pressure on the back side of the cap. Rotate at 180 degrees and continue this process until the cap is finally worked loose from the body. Flip the drum over and remove the other end cap. On this drum, you can see that the end caps seal both ends of the air bladder from leaking by clamping the rubber bladder between the main body and the end caps. Next, we will remove the air bladder by pulling one end over the larger part of the metal flange toward the middle of the drum. This will then allow us to pull the opposite end free of its flange and, with a little pressure on the freed end, remove the bladder entirely. It is important to note that some bladders are glued to the flange using a rubber adhesive. In that case, you will have to pull the end of the bladder free from the adhesive bond and then remove the old adhesive using a rubber solvent or a putty knife. Only you will know if your drum is operating properly. Is it holding air? Is it vibrating on the spindle? An examination of the exterior is a good place to start, but examining the individual components when the drum is disassembled is much more likely to reveal where the issue lies. Look at the body and the end caps to see if there are any burrs or rough spots that could be causing issues. Check to see if the valve stem is loose or needs replacing. Closely examine the bladder for wear, dry rot, or punctures. Once you are satisfied that you have located and repaired any issues, reassemble the drum and test it for air retention. In our fifth and final installment, we will look at proper inflation, how much pressure to use while sanding with a pump sleeve, and how to clean the abrasive sleeve and extend its life.